a new topic, that is network protocols. Network protocols. P. We know in which country you are living in, and you know which state, you know which district, everything you know. But if you don't know the rules and regulations that you have to do when you go outside, when you travel or when you drive a car, then what is the use? You need to know the rules and regulations of that particular country. Am I right, Achyut? If you go in a different country, like say Singapore, you have to follow certain rules and regulations. Am I right? It is very neat and clean. Why?
Rules and regulations are followed.
Because otherwise they have to pay penalty that much amount, or when you go to some European countries. So in the same way, when the networking devices have to communicate in network, it can be in any kind of network or internet, it has to satisfy certain rules and regulations. Like when you buy some things, some electronic devices, you can see an ISI mark or ISO standards. So these are certain rules or standards. Each and every the electronic devices or the wires, cables that has to follow. The same way, the networking devices has to follow certain rules and regulations. These rules and regulations are called as protocols. Like in your school, there are certain protocols, certain uniform you have to wear, certain protocols are the same way. Network has to satisfy certain protocols. Many protocols are there. You have to study only few protocols. The first main protocols are HTTP. HTTP that you have heard already, hypertext transfer. What does P stands for, Srihari?
Protocol.
That's it. Hypertext transfer protocol. Then HTTPS. That you studied 11th standard, right? HTTPS. I have told you about that. Yes. Ashwin, what is HTTPS?
Don't remember, ma'am.
Good answer. Yes, secure. Hypertext transfer protocol, secure. Then what is the next protocol you studied in 11th standard? Krishna Chandran. FTP. What is the full form of FTP, Gauri?
File transfer protocol.
So all these protocols you have to study again. SMTP. Adyan, SMTP. Simple mail transfer protocol. Very good. Telnet, what is the use of Telnet protocol? That's a protocol. Any idea? If Ashwin Binil wants to access the computer of Srihari, what should be done? No facility to go to his house. And how to access? You want to see all the contents, and all the movies he watched, what all the Instagram pages, everything you want to see. You want to access the entire system.
Remote desktop.
So that kind of, you need to install some apps, right? In both the systems?
Yes, ma'am.
So that software is working based on a protocol, Telnet, in order to communicate remote systems. Okay, so this kind of things you need to study. Already you have studied. Few more things. The first one, TCP/IP, that also you studied last year. I have told you about TCP/IP. Transmission Control Protocol bar Internet Protocol. FTP, PPP, point to point protocol. The full form you have to study. Full form plus a few explanations. SMTPs, simple mail transfer, POP3, again, are the protocol you have to study. So we'll start with TCP/IP. I have told you about a foundation. On which foundation all these protocols are built on, which is the basic protocol? Gauri? This is the protocol that we use to transfer data from one network to another. This is the basic protocol. Using this protocol, some other protocols are there, which is used for specific purposes. Who created all these protocols? IDN. The school, who is creating these protocols? There should be someone to create these protocols. Who created this protocol? Your chairman. Uniform chairman. So what about a company? A company will be having a certain protocols, right? The same way here, W3C, the World Wide Web Consortium. Have you heard about IEEE? IEEE. These are many organizations who create ISO, another organization, who are creating. Many people are there working under that. So they are creating these protocols. If you search in W3C site, you can see the different persons or the set of people who are creating these protocols like TCP/IP, FTP, SMTP, etc. HTML, all these languages are created by them. W3C, WWW is World Wide Web. W3C means World Wide Web Consortium. It's an organization, World Wide Web Consortium. Consortium. I guess that is a spelling. Yes, IUM. Yes, consortium. The first protocol is TCP/IP. Next heading. Full formers. Ashwin, full formers.
Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol.
Internet Protocol. What is shake hand? Shake hand. Shaking the hands. Here one word you can see, handshake. Yes, the opposite. How it is working. TCP. So that there are two protocols. Transmission Control Protocol. It's not OR. It is bar Internet Protocol. It's working together. So when we studied packet switching, we know that the data is manual data is divided into small packets. Who's dividing these packets? I mean, this data, who's dividing it? TCP/IP. TCP/IP protocol is dividing all these packets to small packets. That packets are called as datagrams or data packets. So before sending this particular data from system one to system two, say for example, then it checks whether system two is okay or not. First, the connection between sender and receiver is established through a process called handshake. A signal will be passed like an acknowledgement. Once it gets an acknowledgement, it will start sending. Handshake. A signal it is. So there are two duties for TCP. It divides the large packets into small from the source to destination. And at the receiving end, it also reassembles the packets. What it does? Reassembles. And it combines it together and it makes the original message. Multitasking is prohibited. Ashwin, Achyut, and multiple expressions. Ashwin, what is the duty of TCP?
TCP divides large packets to transmit into smaller data packets called datagrams.
Then?
At the receiving end, and it also resembles the packet to form the original message.
Escaped this at this moment. What is Achyut? Achyut, what is the duty of IP?
I was writing the first definition.
That is okay. What is the full form of IP?
Internet protocol.
What is the use of it?
Well, right, ma'am.
I did not tell you what is it. Simply I asked. Okay. IP is used for routing the packets from the source to destination. This protocol's address is called as IP address. Each and every computer has an IP address. This protocol is responsible for providing address of each computer and performing routing. So it finds the IP address of the destination and sends with the IP address. Each packet will be having, like, if you are sending something from Gulf, like cargo, what you will do? Suppose there are three packets, then we'll name it as your address. I mean, the destination address. Your address and the destination address. Sometimes you will write, isn't it? In cartons, we'll write. And this is the packet one. This is the packet two. Something like that. So serial number. Suppose you want to send a message, computer science. CO is one packet. MP is another packet. Suppose. So it will give the name 1, 2, 3. This one will travel through a different route. This MP will travel through a different route. It will find some other route. So at the destination time, what the duty of TCP, it needs to reassemble it. So it will check for the packet number. one will be joined with two, two will be joined with three, etc. Otherwise, the entire message will become a different kind of message. So that is this writing the address and all is done by whom? IP protocol. Clear? Next, file transfer protocol. Instead of writing like HTTP, whenever you open a site, you will get HTTP full colon slash slash www dot, isn't it? Instead of writing this, you have another way of writing FTP full colon slash slash. That is, if you want to transfer a file from one system to another using internet connectivity, I have told you about intranet. In that case, we use what kind of protocol? FTP, file transfer protocol. So for that, we need some apps like FileZilla, etc. You don't have to study much about it. So what is the use? If the question is asked as one more question, Dash allows transferring of files from one system to another. Which protocol it is, Adyan? File transfer protocol.
FTP.
That's all you need to study. Don't have to study the advantages and all. That's all right. So file transfer. So in the name itself, it is there. Then PPP. That is a protocol which is used to send the data from, again, one computer to another computer. How? Point-to-point connection. Suppose, like in older days, internet connection was through telephone lines, cables, isn't it? So that time they used this kind of technology, that is point-to-point protocol. So what is it? About this data link layer, you don't have to study. For that, you need to study OSI and all. You don't have to study in the syllabus. So this is stands for, PPP stands for point-to-point protocol. What is it? It is a communication protocol again, used in network. And it is used to transmit multi-protocol data. Data between, you write only this. It's the communication protocol that is used to transmit data between two directly connected computers. It's like a serial transmission. Only through one direction the data will go. Serial communication, it's not using parallel communication. It's an old technique protocol. Two directly connected. So it will not do some routing and all. Directly it will, direct connection. If it is there, then we can send the data through PPP. Next one is hypertext transfer protocol. When you take a website, obviously you will go to the next page by clicking some link. Am I right, Emmanuel?
Yes, yes.
Okay. You took an Instagram page and we have seen something, so we just want to visit that particular page. So you will have a link and you will click the link. Then it will go to the next page. There another link, I'll click the next page. So that time Instagram Reels you found. So clicked on Instagram Reels. So we are, the transfer is happening between the different links in internet. We use hypertext. So that links are called as hypertext. Hypertext. So in order to transfer hypertext, the protocol used is hypertext transfer protocol. If you are searching for some content in Google, we can see many links. Click on the link, then next page will reach. then in that page also you'll click on some link or you'll click on the back. So that's what that's how this particular thing is working. So when you type something in Google, from where is the result is coming? In which browser you are searching this particular content, that is called as a client. Okay, suppose you are using Internet Explorer or if you are using Google Chrome, that is your client, that is your browser. It sends a request to the server. Then the server is giving the response back to the client. That is how this HTTP is working. So it is client and server over web communicate using HTTP protocol. Client is requesting, server is serving. So that is how HTTP protocol works. Only this much you need to write. What is it? Basically, expand the terms. This will be the question from this particular topic. Finished? Next. SMTP. Transmit email over the internet. This transmit is very important. Transmit or sending the mail. For sending mail, we use SMTP. For receiving mail, we use other protocol. So sending the emails to some other mails, you'll use SMTP only for sending. How you're getting your mails in your inbox, that is done by a different protocol. Understood? Krishnandran? Sending is done by SMTP. There comes top three protocols used for receiving. Receiving, we use which protocol, Alvin? Email is received. It is used for downloading and receiving messages on your mailbox, or it can be Outlook. What is Outlook? What is Outlook? Have you used Outlook? Yes. Yes.
Used by Microsoft.
Product of Microsoft. What is it? What is it? Hello, what is it? I'm asking you, Achyut, what is it?
It's just an email.
It is just an email, no? It's an application software. What is it? What is the use of it? Any idea, Srihari?
Microsoft Mail software, just like
email. Not only mails, mail, Microsoft Mail. Suppose you are a businessman and you have lots of mails. Email IDs, and you have to, send mails, and you need to receive mails. Urgent messages will come into the inbox. So every time you don't have time, time is precious or precious. You don't have time to open each and every, Gmails or the some other mail, MSN mails and all. So what we will do in Outlook, we will add our account and password of different mails. Okay, so everything you will configure. Then whenever you want to send a message, you just open Outlook and send the message. even if there is no internal connectivity, whenever the connection is established, automatically Outlook will send the message. Whenever we receive some message, automatically it will come into the Outlook inbox. So you don't have to open different windows. Everything will be in a single window. So that downloading and coming into the mail box is in Outlook, and that kind of softwares are using which protocol? Post Office protocol, POP3 protocol. Okay. Post Office protocol version 3.0. That's why it is called POP3. See, user can read them and it will be saved automatically. Suppose you are opening Gmail, there is no internet connection. Will it open, Dia?
No, ma'am.
No, but the specialty of Outlook is that once we open, once we our inbox is there, it will be there. So it will be automatically downloaded. You can receive it. You can view it at any time, even if you are not connected to the internet. Then there are different versions and port numbers are given. Next one is VoIP. Voice over IP. Voice over internet protocol. How many of your parents are abroad? Abroad, in Gulf countries or in Europe, America, etc. So how you call your, who's that?
Aryan.
Yes, Aryan. In which country?
Dubai.
Dubai. So how you'll call your father or mother? Is it possible to call through WhatsApp?
No.
No, it's banned. Then yes. Which software you are using?
There's an app called Botim.
What about Kuwait? Anybody is there in Kuwait? Kuwait is not banned, it's free. In some countries, it is free. So before this evolution of internet and it is WhatsApp calls, how will you call? How will you make an international call? Achyut.
Like in the telephone center, we should pay some extra cash and they will...
Trunk call, isn't it? It's called as trunk call. Or when in your mobile phone, what you will do? That's for per minute, some 24 rupees or 12 rupees per minute, they will charge. But when this kind of WhatsApp or some other softwares, apps are released, so now we can call freely through internet. So how it is possible? It is possible because of this protocol. What protocol? The protocol name is VoIP, voice over IP. It is a protocol that enables voice communication over the internet. Example is WhatsApp calls. It uses packet switching. So actually your voice is going in the form of packets. Only for voice communication we use this. Voice over IP. Internet calls. Internet calls. We use VoIP. What can be the speciality? What is the advantage? What is the disadvantage? What is the advantage? We can save a lot of money.
Yes.
Then there is a disadvantage. Sometimes it is like an advantage. We can't track the location through WhatsApp calls. We can't track. Normal, using SIM card, we can track the location using towers. Tower location you can track. But WhatsApp calls, and you can't track the location. Yes.
So what about like virtual SIMs and all?
Virtual?
SIM cards.
VPN you are telling about?
No, ma'am. In some other foreign countries and all, they are using like a net card or something.
Yes. That you have to pay separately. Am I right, Aryan? Aryan is gone. Atul, Aryan, Srihari, turn on your video. Aryan. I think Aryan is feeling so hungry. So we have certain applications available. Aryan, which software are you using in order to call? Then this one is remote login. Remote login that you have to study, this Telnet. It's what I told you. It is used for remote login. This is a software that you know, isn't it? TeamViewer software. There's another thing is AnyDesk. So this application permits you to share your computer with, they can access, one can access some other's desktop directly. And the user need ID of the computer generated in the remote login application. So suppose you are downloading TeamViewer software, you need TeamViewer software in your system and the other system that you want to communicate. Then it will generate a user ID. How many of you have used this TeamViewer? No one.
Ma'am, I have used AnyDesk.
Okay. Then anybody use this TeamViewer or InDesk? No one. One day you just show them how to use Achyut, this remote. Then you can access someone else and their desktop.
But the system becomes very slow, right?
No, if you have both have fair net connection, it will work the same way you work on your system.
No, also in Zoom also we can use.
Zoom?
Yeah, we can use remote desktop.
Remote desktop is you can use, yes. We can share with remote desktop. See, if you use those who haven't used this particular thing yet, suppose Aryan system has some complaints. Suppose now it's working perfectly. Suppose some complaint and Achyut knows how to fix it. Aryan can't go to Achyut's house because of this COVID pandemic situations. So what you will do, both have internet connection. So what you will do, Achyut and Aryan in both the systems, suppose the problem is with some app, Spider. He is not able to download Spider properly. So he doesn't know what is the problem. So what he will do, both will install. I have used only TeamViewer. It will work the same way as that other software. So Aryan system, TeamViewer software should be installed, and Achyut system also TeamViewer software should be installed, and it will generate a ID. Okay, Aryan, it will generate an ID. That particular ID you have to give to Achyut. So if Achyut is entering that particular ID, then it will ask you for the permission. So just click on OK. Then okay. So and who did it for you? Aditya, but he's not here. So Aditya and Achu already utilize this particular thing for installing MySQL. Very good. So Achu can directly view the from the desktop onwards, and they are thing of Aryan system. He can do anything like he yes, he actually will feel that he is using his own system, but actually it is Aryan system, and anytime you can close it, so the connection will be lost. So that is how this works, and the protocol used is Telnet, T-E-L-N-E-T. Telnet is a protocol we use. Any other protocols are there? So you study only Telnet. So Telnet is one of the protocols, remote protocols. This is a protocol used for accessing remote computers. Working, you don't have to study. Working, you don't have to study. Mobile communication protocol, we'll see in the next class, wireless protocols. So that's all for today. It's too much, isn't it? Too much, three much, four much. So let's go with the other thing. That is the next game in that, what is that? I forgot. What was that, Achal? Do you remember? AI game, Semantris. Now what should you share the screen? Share screen. One more game is there so that you can try. Blocks.
And blocks, right?
Yes, yes. Yes. Thinking as a like a human being, right? Blocks should, you have to break the blocks. Only then you can. About umbrella, you type something, rain. Okay. So we have to check how you can break the blocks here, that ship umbrella. Only then the topmost blocks will go. Yes, very good. Oh. Very good. 2,550 points. Who want to play, Dia? Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.